Hi everyone, in this video we are going to demonstrate how to implement OAuth 2.0 authentication for APIs in Software AG WebMethods API Gateway. OAuth 2.0 is the industry standard protocol for authorization. OAuth 2.0 focuses on client-developer simplicity while providing specific authorization flows for web applications, desktop applications, mobile phones, and living room devices. To implement OAuth authentication, we began by logging into the API Gateway. For the list of APIs deployed in the API Gateway, let us select an API to apply the OAuth authentication. In this case, we selected AddNumbers API. This is a simple API which will add two numbers passed as input and will return their sum. As you can see, this API is hosted on local integration server localhost 5511, and the gateway endpoint for this API is as shown. We need to create at least one scope for this API that can be enabled for access through one access token. Different access tokens can have access to different scopes of the same API. For now, we will create a scope named GetScope on this API. And add get method to this scope. After this, we need to set up policies for this API to enable OAuth authentication. First, set up transport policy by clicking on edit button and selecting enable HTTP or HTTPS policy under transport section. This will create a policy tail for the selected policy. In the properties section, on right side, select relevant checkboxes, HTTP, HTTPS or both. Make sure to select get scope in the drop down to apply this policy to the correct scope. In the identify and access section, select the policy for identify and authorize application. In the right side, we need to select condition as and to apply all the identification and authentication types. Allow anonymous as we have not defined any authorized user in the gateway to access this API scope, and select identification type as OAuth 2 token. In routing tab, we need to select outbound authentication, transport policy to add the type. In the properties section on right, select the authentication schema as OAuth 2 and authentication mode as incoming OAuth 2 token. The next step is to create an application. Let us name it as edition. Go to application menu option and select create application and enter name as edition. Version as 1.0. Continue to API section and enter AddNumbers API name in the find API box. Select the API so that it gets added to the application. In the authentication section, click on create strategy. In this, select authentication schema as OAuth 2 Enter OAuth strategy as the name. Authentication server as local. Click on generate credentials and select application type as public. In this application profile, select as web. By default, in the next field, token lifetime will be 3600 seconds. And if we want, we can reduce that number. And enter token refresh limit as 0 so that access token can be refreshed unlimited number of times. If you want to restrict access to refresh only few times, then enter corresponding value such as 5. In the redirect URLs field, add one or more redirect URLs for the responses, since we will use Postman for testing this API. We have given the callback URL of Postman in this field. Select the grant type as per our requirement. In this case, we will use authorization code. More than one grant type can also be selected. Select the scope for this available list which this authentication should apply. On saving this application, client ID and client secret will be created by the API gateway for accessing this application from the specific client, in this case Postman. In some time, we will show where to enter this client ID and client secret in Postman. Now let's see how we can use OAuth 2.0 authentication to invoke this API from Postman. Open Postman and create a new API request in the URL. Enter the API gateway endpoint of addNumbers API. Select the method as get. In authorization tab, enter type as OAuth 2.0. Then click on get new access token button. We will open a form. In the form, enter a token name, in this case test. Select grant type as authorization code. Enter callback URL same as what was entered in the application definition in API gateway. Auth URL should be entered as shown here with the URL ending authorize. Auth token URL should be entered as shown here ending with get access token. Enter the client ID and client secret generated in the API gateway earlier. Enter the scope name that was created in the API gateway. Click on request token, which will open a new window for API gateway resource access approval, where the scopes to be approved should be selected. In this case, it is get scope. Once it is approved, Postman will receive the bearer token, and this token could be used to invoke the addNumbers API service. Enter the input parameters for this service in params tab of Postman to get desired response from API gateway. Thank you.